In this lecture, we will understand what is the demodulation of the amplitude modulated signal and the demodulation of the amplitude modulated signal by using Square Law Demodulator. The process of extracting the original information carrying signal from a modulated carrier signal is known as demodulation. This process is defined as the procedure that is applied. A graphical representation of the demodulation process can be given by: a demodulator is an electrical circuit that is primarily employed to extract the information content or message signal from the modulated carrier signal. A demodulator will provide an output signal that is either the original version of the message signal or a scaled version of it. The signal may be described as sound, graphics, or binary data. It can be done by using Square Law Demodulator, envelope detection, and synchronous detection. In this lecture, we will understand what is a Square Law Demodulator and how the Square Law Demodulator functions to demodulate amplitude modulated signal to generate message signal. Square Law Demodulator is used to demodulate amplitude modulated signal or extract the original message signal by using a Square Law device such as diode. It is used in the demodulation of low quality amplitude modulated signal. Square Law means the output provided by the diode will be square of the input. Let us see the circuit diagram for the Square Law Demodulator. The demodulator circuit contains a modulating signal source or amplitude modulated signal generator X1T and the Square Law device such as diode, and the output of this diode is X2T, and the resistor R and the capacitor C will form a low pass filter. Output of the low pass filter formed by using resistor R1 and the capacitor C1 is a desired demodulated signal X0 or the message signal. Let us see the block diagram for this Square Law modulator. At first, the amplitude modulated signal X1T is given as an input to the Square Law device such as diode to produce the output signal X2T. The output signal from the diode is X2T is given as an input to the low pass filter. Output of the low pass filter after elimination of the higher order terms is our desired demodulated signal or message signal. Amplitude modulated signal can be written mathematically as X1T is equal to AC into 1 plus KA into MT into cos 2 pi FCT. This signal is given as an input to the Square Law device, which is a diode. The transfer characteristics of the Square Law device is nonlinear, and it can be written in the form of the output of the Square Law device, or X2T is equal to K1 into X1T plus K2 into X1T whole square. If we put the value of X1T or AC into 1 plus KA into MT into cos 2 pi FCT in the equation of X2T, then it can be written as X2T is equal to K1 into AC into 1 plus KA into MT into cos 2 pi FCT plus K2 into AC into 1 plus KA into MT into cos 2 pi FCT whole square. Now, if we take AC common from the first term and AC square common from the second term, then X2T can be written as X2T is equal to K1 into AC into 1 plus KA into MT into cos 2 pi FCT plus K2 into AC square into 1 plus KA into MT whole square into cos square 2 pi FCT. Now, if we divide and multiply the second term by 2, then second term will become K2 into AC square divided by 2 into 1 plus KA into MT whole square into 2 cos square 2 pi FCT. If we apply the formula of 2 cos square 2 pi FCT, then it can be written as 1 plus cos 4 pi FCT. Now, we need to multiply K2 into AC square divided by 2 into 1 plus 2 into KA into MT plus KA square into M square T with the terms 1 and cos 4 pi FCT. Then the equation will become X2T is equal to K1 into AC into 1 plus KA into M cos 2 pi FCT plus K2 into AC square divided by 2 into 1 plus 2 into KA into MT plus KA square into MT square into cos 4 pi FCT plus K2 into AC square divided by 2 into 1 plus 2 into KA into MT plus K square into M square T. Further simplification can be done by multiplying K2 into AC square divided by 2 with the terms 1 plus 2 into KA into MT plus KA square into M square T. So finally, X2T can be written as K1 into AC into 1 plus KA into MT into cos 2 pi FCT plus K2 into AC square divided by 2 into 1 plus 2 into KA into MT plus ka square into m square t into cos 4 pi fct plus k2 into ac square divided by 2 plus 2 into k2 into ac square divided by 2 into ka into mt plus k2 into ac square divided by 2 ka square into mt square. Identify this as equation number 2. Then the output of the square law device or x2t is passed through a low pass filter. The low pass filter allows all the low frequency components below the cutoff frequency to pass but attenuates all the high frequency components above the cutoff frequency. Here, the frequency of the low pass filter is given. Passband is the frequency range where the filter allows the signal to pass and it is above the cutoff frequency, and stopband is the frequency range where filter attenuates the signal and it is below the cutoff frequency. In the equation 2, high frequency terms are k1 into ac into 1 plus ka into mt into cos 2 pi fct and k2 into ac square divided by 2 into 1 plus 2 into ka into mt into ka square into mt square whole square into cos 4 pi fct. And another term is k2 into ac square divided by 2 into ka square into m square t. And the constant term is k2 into ac square divided by 2. Due to the low pass filter, all the high frequency terms are cancelled out and the constant term can be cancelled out by using coupling capacitor. And the output of the low pass filter can be given by k2 into ac square divided by 2 into 2 into ka into mt, which can be simplified as k2 into ac square into ka into mt. This is the scaled version of message signal, where message signal is scaled by the factors k2, ac square and ka. This means that we have recorded the message signal mt at the output of the detector. Now let us understand how the distortion takes place in the detector's output. After passing the output of the square law device through the low pass filter and a coupling capacitor, the remaining terms will be k2 into ac square divided by 2 into 2 into ka into mt and k2 into ac square divided by 2 ka square into m square t. First signal is our desired signal. The second signal is unwanted and it gives rise to the distortion. The ratio of the desired signal to the unwanted signal can be given by k2 into ac square divided by 2 into 2 into ka into mt divided by k2 into ac square divided by 2 into ka square into m square t, which can be simplified as 2 divided by ka into mt. In order to minimize the distortion, this ratio needs to be maximized. To achieve this, it is necessary to choose a value of Ka into mt as the smallest compared to the unity for all the values of t. If Ka is small, then amplitude modulated signal is weak. If the amplitude modulated signal is weak, then the percentage modulation is also very small. This means that the distortion in the detector's output is low if and only if the applied amplitude modulation is weak and if the percentage of modulation is very small. That's all for this lecture. If you have any doubts regarding this lecture, then you may ask it in the comment section. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.